perhaps one of the areas that El Camino Hospital has become best known for is treatment of peripheral arterial disease. And basically what that is blocked arteries in the legs. This is a problem that affects at least 20 million people in America. It's thought to impact 5 to 10% of individuals 55 years of age and older, and is probably the strongest marker of risk for heart attack and stroke in patients in America. The testing to determine whether someone has peripheral arterial disease is really simple. It can be done with a blood pressure cuff. The treatment is very effective, and it also is important to recognize this because obviously it then turns our eye on the heart and the brain and makes sure that we're doing all the things that we should do to prevent major problems for our patients. Now, peripheral vascular disease can present itself in a couple of different ways, and there's a broad spectrum. Patients who smoke, patients who are diabetic, patients who carry all the typical cardiac risk factors are at increased risk for peripheral arterial disease. The thing about peripheral arterial disease, though, is over time, it has a very, very high risk of death. At 5 years after the diagnosis of peripheral arterial disease, the likelihood of survival is reduced by 25%. That's greater than or equal to colon cancer, Hodgkin's disease, some other things that people pay a lot more attention to. When you get advanced stages of peripheral arterial disease, that number goes up precipitously to the point that survival is of grave concern, not because people die from peripheral arterial disease, but because it affects them in the form of stroke and heart attack, which obviously can be fatal. Patients that have this problem oftentimes complain of fatigue, tiredness, or discomfort in their legs. The typical pattern is they can walk a certain distance, after which they have to stop because their legs really won't allow them to go any further. They rest for a few minutes, the blood recirculates in the legs, they resume their walking and can go a similar distance before stopping again. A lot of times this problem is blamed on old age, on immobility, on living a sedentary life. Some people think it's arthritis. It can affect the hip, the buttocks, the thighs, more commonly the calf muscles and the feet, but these are problems that tend to come on very slowly, so people don't pay attention to them as much as, as getting a cold where something's wrong all of a sudden. This has got a slow, progressive onset, and people tend to adjust to it. They find a park bench where they want to sit in the park so that they can, break up their walk. They use a scooter in a grocery store or push a cart, which seems to make things a little bit easier. But ultimately, the long-term impact on the quality of life in these individuals is that they become more sedentary, they are not cardiovascularly fit, and that increases their risk of developing heart attack and stroke. This problem goes on even further if it's not paid attention to, especially in diabetics, where it can become something that causes critical limb ischemia, which means your leg is at risk of being amputated. People who have leg discomfort, people who can't feel their feet, people who have ulcers or early signs of gangrene or black ulcers of the foot, ultimately need care right away. At El Camino, we've been extremely effective at treating these problems, taking the patients who have claudication or simple lifestyle limitations and restoring adequate blood supply to their legs so that they can roam freely and be well, taking patients who have true limb-threatening problems and in a 90 to 95% likelihood able to save their limbs and get them back on their feet literally. When people get to the point that they require or undergo an amputation, the mortality increase in those folks is pretty severe. Greater than half of those folks are dead within a couple of years because of the loss of mobility, because of the density of plaque that's in their body. And so this is a very important problem to pay attention to. And we pride ourselves here on having every tool imaginable and many that are not readily available at other hospitals to help us succeed in the battle to restore blood flow to legs, to keep legs attached and where they're supposed to be, and to keep people moving and moving towards good health. So the key to success really in treating blocked arteries in the legs is you need to find somebody who's very experienced, and you need to go to a center that has every tool imaginable. If you're being given advice that your only option is an amputation, you need another opinion. Amputation is a treatment of last resort. I can't tell you how many times we found patients that were told that was their option, and we found that there were other options that actually saved the leg and got them functional again. If you're being told your only option is a surgical bypass, quite frankly, there are other options available that are much less impacting on you, much less invasive. The key again is getting to a center, getting to a physician that can understand the value of all the options that are on the table. The key here is we're happy to work with any physician, any discipline. We do this on a regular basis. We routinely train the doctors on the West Coast to come in and learn new techniques. So we're very used to dealing with patients locally and patients from afar who have these difficult to treat problems. We can treat them with a simple puncture. People oftentimes go home the same day. Even bypass surgery, we've now figured out a way to do this without any surgery at all. So options are really unlimited as long as you be your own advocate, find out what your options truly are, and be aggressive about your healthcare.